Calculus in higher dimensions can be confusing. You know, it's hard enough to deal with derivatives and integrals of a function of one variable. When you get to a function of several variables, it can be downright hard. But there's a mantra that you keep repeating yourself and will get you through 408M, 408D, 427L. It's one variable at a time. So let's suppose we got a function of two variables. So we got a function that depends on x and y. So it's defined in this region over here. Here we are sitting at a particular point. And we want to understand how that function is changing. Well, a derivative is supposed to be the rate of change. But a rate of change in what direction? Side to side? Up and down? Diagonal? There are lots and lots of different directions. But the simplest thing you can do is to just say, let's figure out what happens when we just change x and ignore y. Well, if we do that, y takes on a particular value. And our function of x and y becomes a function of x with a particular value of y plugged in. Y is now a constant. And you can take a derivative along that curve. If you want to know what's happening when you change x but don't change y, well, we call that a partial derivative, and that's the limit as h goes to 0 of f of x plus h y minus f of x y divided by h. We're just taking derivative the usual way, going sideways, treating y as if it's a constant. If you want to know df dy, that's a partial derivative in the y direction, that's just treat x as a constant. That tells you what happens when you move up and down. So what happens if you move diagonally? Well, if you're going to, if you move in any direction, any motion is equal to an x motion plus a y motion. You tell me how far you move horizontally, and I'll tell you how much the function changes because of the derivative in the x direction. Tell me how much you move vertically, and I'll tell you how much the function changes because of the derivative in the y direction. Put them together, and you get the rate of change in any direction. If you take derivatives one variable at a time, treating all of your the other variables as constants, you learn a tremendous amount about the function. What about integrals? Suppose you want to integrate over a region like this. So you want to do the integral over this region of some function dx dy. Well, remember, an integral is getting the whole as a sum of the parts. So we'll chop this up into little pieces. So we get that the total integral is basically the sum over all the strips of the integral over the strip. And so that's going to be an integral with respect to x of the integral over the strip. But how do you get an integral over a strip? Well, you chop the strip into pieces. Into little boxes, and you add up all the little boxes. So that's going to be the integral over all the strips, and the integral for each, and the contribution of each strip is going to be the integral with respect to y of f of xy. So if you want to do find out what the total contribution of this whole region is, you chop it up vertically, and then you chop each piece up horizontally, and then you take the appropriate limits. The integral over the whole region is the integral over x of the integral over y of the function. Now, of course, you could do it the other way. You could first chop things into horizontal strips and break those into pieces. You know, what is the right order of chopping things up depends on the problem. but you always look for ways to chop things up so that you're only doing one variable at a time. Whether it's derivatives or integrals, that mantra, one variable at a time, will get you through multivariable calculus.